Yeah. City going up, so you better bust. Been in serious, really wanna us. Yeah. Everybody tough, today gotta go and see the. Yeah. Better hush. Remember growing up, all I wanted was to be a. Wanted me a. Yeah. To get a little bread. Still outside, I don't hide from it for life. Had to fight for my life, took them hits and strike. If I for the guys, have my candlelight going up like the club. After that, go slide. Are you with that? I won't get back. I'm gon' hop out. Are you with that? I want big racks. I'm gon' flock. I'm gon' stack. Are you with that? Won't forget that I saw in my past. Are you with that? Like I'm with that. Yeah. 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 Whenever I miss those days, visit my LA. Under the ground, running around, we was them kids that play. All in the street, following leads, who lost their way. Some of them outside still, some of them, yeah. I'm a real beach boy, come ride my way. Left me with the either or, fill these voids and fill my bank. Blue strips only, you switched on me, mama told me about you snakes. Keep my, you know you can't never be too safe. Are you with that? I won't get back. I'm gon' hop out. Yeah. Are you with that? I want big racks. I'm gon' flock. I'm gon' stack. Are you with that? Won't forget that shit I saw in my past. Are you with that? Like I'm with that. Yeah.
Call Screech. I be gone.
Yeah.
They gon' wanna know how they come.
Yeah.
Get back. Up first, bet not miss that. Tell me if you with that.
My baby, my Valentine. Yeah. Can I do making my temperature rise? If you leave me, I'm good. I swear. You are like the oxygen I need to survive. I'll be honest. Loving the thought of me, I am so obsessed. I want to. Nobody did it. Make us feel love. Make a bad man. Talk all they want, I don't care what they say, cause your mother. Now in my con, they carry for my head every night. Now you are one day. No, 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 don't tell me, no, no, no. You can be my partner, never riding solo, no. And we got lucky, no need to. I feel it, what you're doing, no, yeah, baby, gotta go, gotta go. Oh, no, no, your body, they. Oh, no, make us feel low. Now you already got my fancy. Don't they do me, I keep on.
I'm Brian Anderson, at the table with Grant Hill and Brent Berry. Our reporter is Allie LaForce. So Sacramento will get the first possession here. Fox outside. Driving to the basket.
Play control. We have De'Aaron Fox cleared for takeoff.
Guess what, guys? I mean, one of the ways De'Aaron Fox improved his skills growing up was playing 2K, learning the NBA game on 2K. I love it.
Shot clock at 6. Here's Morris. And he got the whistle on the way up, so he'll be headed to the line for a pair. That'll belong to Domantas Sabonis.
First team foul.
Yeah, and you never want to let shots at the rim go uncontested.
That free throw, no good. And De'Aaron, playing 2K growing up, his dad encouraged him to observe. Take note.
Good advice. I mean, De'Aaron learned a lot about things like ball screens, pick and roll from playing video games, stuff like that. I mean, Fox used 2K as a way to study the game of basketball.
Gotta love the effort there. An undersized four who can really make things happen with that leaping ability.
Beal, right side. And then Beal with the Thunder Jam.
Great athleticism. Bradley Beal with his steps down and rams it.
They kick it out to Murray. That three's off the mark. It's Beal on the wing. A little over a minute and a half into this first quarter. To the inside. Porzingis. Oh, it's Porzingis with the jam.
And Beal finding a guy with a better look that time.
Here's Fox. And Fox powers it home.
When you're trying to stop a guy like this, you have to match his intensity levels.
Beal outside. There's the drive. Perfect night so far, 2 for 2.
That's some flashy footwork there from Bradley Beal.
Outside Mitchell.
The first thing I think of when watching Davion Mitchell is defense. Mitchell entered the league as one of the best on-the-ball defenders out there.
And no doubt, Davion Mitchell is an elite defensive. Why is that, Grant?
Well, B.A., despite standing 6 feet, he's got a 6'5 wingspan. Mitchell is really strong and quick. But the biggest thing, Davion never takes a possession off.
Now here's Morris. And here in the first, approaching 3 minutes play. Nifty move. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line.
Second personal foul.
Monte Morris is a nice second point guard to have on the roster. A very good scorer who contributes in a lot of other ways.
And with Monte Morris, he's been steady throughout his career.
Well, I tell you what, Washington did a good job picking up a stud like this. He shoots a high percentage. He takes care of the ball. He's someone that the coach is going to give a lot of responsibility to. And this team has needed a player like this for the past couple seasons.
And that one's good. Porzingis.
This is what an offense is supposed to do. You look for a high percentage shot, and Porzingis the beneficiary.
Timeout called. Sacramento. Outside. And Fox powers it home.
How about Fox getting up on the inside? Love to see the point guard rise up.
And first quarter, we're about 3.5 minutes in. Here's Wright. Always a nice way to start. Makes his first one.
Getting enough shots in close to play inside out.
Fox with the ball. Barton covering. On the wing, Mitchell. Pass to Lyles. Out to Fox. Pocket four. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
Finding more and more ways is De'Aaron Fox to score the basketball. That time gets contact.
had a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for the Kings.
Well, guys, early on, they're driving the lane constantly, using their quickness to gain an advantage. Look at their points off penetration.
Beal from outside. Oh, and he can't make that one. 2 for 3 now, his first miss. Last season, Washington was hot out of the gates. They started 10-3, but things did not end well.
You know, and after that hot start, B.A., a 25-44 ending for the Wizards, failing to make the play-in game as well. Just a disappointing season after the promise Washington showed early.
Here's Porzingis. Oh, he missed the layup. He had it with the pump fake.
For him, it's harder to miss that shot than it is to make that shot. I think he was anticipating a bit of a bump there.
Assisted.
Yeah, undersized guys with athleticism do these kind of things, playing above the rim. I'd love to see him get up like that.
Timeout called, the Wizards. Washington trailing. Now here's Wright. To the middle. Here's Gafford. And he buries his first look.
Coaching staff would like some more shots from that range.
Right side Monk. Pass to Herder. From behind the arc. Gafford grabs the miss. Right outside. There's the double with Herder. And here's Gafford. Avdija from outside. Rebounded by Lyles.
Looks like the game plan is they're willing to give him that kind of shot. It worked out for them this time, but if they give it to him again, I bet 3 points are coming.
About 7 seconds separating the shot and game clocks. Just 5 to shoot. Back to Holmes. Over Gafford. And that one hits the back iron.
Well, I'm not sure if family and friends are here in the stands tonight, but we wanted to show that one off. Fading away on the shot was absolutely not necessary.
Well, good close contest so far as we finish the first.
15.
If you're just joining us, it's been a pretty even game through the first quarter. And what do you think about the Kings here, guys?
Well, we've watched them force their way to the line, and it seems to be working so far.
Such a great way to silence hostile fans who want the up and down pace that gets them amped up. Instead, everyone's just standing around watching the free throw game.
The Kings leading.
The league's attitude towards the mid-range shot has changed quite a bit, and Harrison Barnes may reflect that more than anyone.
And the shot's good.
You got to get all over Sabonis. Any kind of crack down there, he's going to find it and find a way to score.
It's Avdija on the wing. Well, he hasn't put up any points yet in this one. Now with Barnes, it wasn't too long ago that he really relied on the mid-range jumper.
Yeah, B.A., you go back just a few seasons to 2017, and he was in the league's top 10 in mid-range attempts. And now you just don't ever see him operate there. It's either threes or getting all the way to the rim. So the shot diet for HB has changed.
The shot off that time. So Sacramento will take it the other way. Inside. Fox, that's good.
De'Aaron Fox.
Fox has got 11 points.
Well, Fox, not a jump shooter, just doing a great job of mixing it up offensively now.
Oh, Sabonis with a block. Down low. Fox, that's De'Aaron good. Fox. And it's a 9-point Kings lead.
That's been the story of their offense so far, getting a number of looks from point-blank range.
Pass to Avdija. Here's Kispert. No good with a layup.
Practically a block. Good, strong challenge.
Yeah, altering the shot, just as long as there's a miss, that kind of energy not wasted.
Oh, it's stolen by Achimura. And let's send it over to Allie LaForce.
Thanks a lot. Well, Brian, the Wizards have been aggressively reshaping their roster. What they haven't done is tear it down and start a rebuild. That's often the most popular route for teams stuck in the middle, but the Wizards seem to be hoping they can catch lightning in a bottle. Back to you.
No appetite for the restart, Allie.
Thanks.
On offense, here are the Kings. They've only given up 2 points this quarter. Murray for three. No good there. Now Washington takes it the other way. Fast break, here we go. And it's slammed in by Achimura.
And you can see the agility from Rui Hachimura. Fantastic job just getting out and converting.
Back to Murray. Outside Barnes. They get it again. On the wing, Mitchell. Back to Barnes. Pass to Sabonis. Goes up again. Achimura with a rebound. Gafford with the ball. Here in the second quarter, just under 3.5 minutes played. Misses from short range. Fox.
De'Aaron Fox.
The shot is good on the assist by Sabonis.
Timeout on the floor.
Fox has got 6 points in the quarter. Now a timeout called by Washington. So it's both teams making substitutions here. Grant, it's a shooter's league, and we're seeing more and more big men float out to the perimeter and knocking them down.
Well, B.A., the game has evolved, and the shooting, particularly from the bigs, is fantastic.
But, you know, I wish the bigs had a little bit more diversity. I don't mind shooting from the perimeter, but every once in a while, go mix it up and take advantage of your size mismatch in the paint.
Back come the Kings in transition. Here's Bazemore. It's Herder on the wing.
2 minutes remaining in the second quarter.
Pass to Metu. Back to Herder. Down to five on the shot clock. Let's the three fly. Counted from distance. Herder's gotten himself on the board with a three there.
Well, that's who Herder is outside on the perimeter. A confident long-range shooter.
Back to Barton. The three is up. Counted. One for one to start the game.
And both teams running long-range plays that are working.
Well, both of them looking towards the three-point line. And I like to see that, especially when the results are made buckets.
And out of bounds, the Wizards will take it.
Well, during the summer of 2021, Rashawn Holmes signed a 4-year contract worth about $45 million. That's a pretty big prize for a guy coming out of a JUCO.
Offensive board. Pass to Beal. Fires the three. And the Wizards with another three.
Advantageous if you can get in Bradley Beal's airspace before he catches. Otherwise, that happens.
Washington trailing. His fourth make in five tries. Solid start for him.
This takes advantage of the D in a way that very few players playing today can do.
Pass to Metu. Outside Monk. Fires for three. Pure from three-point range.
The defense really fell apart there. You can't afford to leave him all alone at the arc.
Now Beal. This one for three. And the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Holmes.
Washington. Kings substitution. Trey Lyles.
19 seconds left in the first half. Oh, it's Porzingis with the jam.
I don't
know who's going to get up for that as Porzingis skies for the dunk.
Monk for three. Washington with a rebound. Monk with a steal. And we're through the first half of play here in what's been a good one. The Kings on top, up by three. And don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of quarter number three. And we've got second half action for you. Thus far, a pretty evenly contested game. Beal outside. This for the tie! The shot, no good. Now Sacramento takes it the other way. They've led by as much as 10. Pass to Murray. And the foul called on Kristaps Porzingis. That'll be a second foul of the game.
These calls can be so difficult for officials to make.
Fox right side. Outside Murray.
Like the defense from Beal, doing whatever he could to alter that one.
Murray, no good.
Yeah, the shocker of the 2022 trade deadline. A deal centered around Domantas Sabonis going to Sacramento and Tyrese Haliburton sent to Indy.
There's the foul. It's on Will Barton. That's his first foul.
Personal foul. Second team foul.
And Sacramento has possession. They lead by one. Here's Fox. That one falls. Nice feed from Sabonis. Fox has got 17. That blockbuster Sabonis-Haliburton trade. What do you make of it for the Kings?
Well, you know, B.A., Sacramento was a guard-heavy team. Sabonis adds size. He also adds playmaking, and I love his motor. I think it was a move to even out their roster. And he gives up some size inside, but makes a great adjustment on the finish.
Yeah, the big man not going to slow him down from getting that deuce.
Sabonis can't hit.
Ooh, he missed an easy chance to put some points on the board. He won't get a much better look at that kind of shot again here probably tonight.
Here's Beal. And then Beal with the dunk.
This is when the teammates feed off of Bradley Beal when he has it going like this.
Fox with the ball. Beal picks him up. And De'Aaron Fox picks up the foul. That's his first foul of the game.
And just a great job of getting there first and absorbing the contact.
They are looking really strong offensively.
Yeah, just terrific momentum. Let's see if they can keep it up.
And look at the ups on Kyle Kuzma.
The Kings trailing. It's Barnes on the wing. Outside Murray. Over Kuzma. Tries again. And scoring with the play inside is Barnes.
Maybe the length helping out Harrison Barnes that time to collect.
Beal outside. Oh, he airballs the triple. That one was way off. Left side Mitchell. Takes the three. Buries it from three. 5 points in the game.
That's a pretty easy opportunity for a teammate, all courtesy of Harrison Barnes.
Three-pointer, Beal, rebounded by Fox.
And look at this summer, a 5-year extension for Bradley Beal. One of the richest contracts in NBA history, over $240 million.
Three from Barnes, that one is off. Pretty even game going on here in D.C. And Beal launches from deep. And they'll get another chance. Kuzma outside. Six to shoot. From outside the arc. It's rebounded by Sabonis. And he's certainly elite. But does it surprise you that Bradley Beal has one of the biggest contracts in the NBA, Grant?
And that's just how it works. I mean, give it a few years and all the stars will be paid the same. That said, it must be nice. Those are some big checks.
A
Sabonis, such a huge asset to this team, plays the four and the five spot really well. Very good passer. And he's deserved the two All-Star appearances in the Eastern Conference.
And it's Sacramento's ball. Good momentum. Eight straight points. Here's Metu. No good on the three. And the Wizards with possession here. Trailing by five. And how about the impact that Sabonis has had thus far, Brent?
Well, the reliability, B.A., is down there on the glass and doing the dirty work, trying to grab those boards and get some scrappy points in the paint. That's what Sabonis is all about. So he's got the entire package as an inside player.
Let's check in with our reporter, Allie LaForce.
Thanks, B.A. Bradley Beal played for Coach Greg Popovich with the U.S. national team, and Pop said, quote, he's hard to keep up with. His balance and movement are very impressive. He stops on a dime, can pull up and shoot. That, along with his excellent footwork, are the most impressive things for me. Brian?
Yeah, great breakdown there, Allie. Thank you. Here's Holmes. Oh, it's Holmes with the big jam.
What a show of strength by Holmes, going up hard and jamming it in.
Right on the right side. To the wing, right side. Hachimura outside. And here's Kispert from the arc. And again, Washington with a triple.
Well, Hachimura not known as a playmaker, but unselfish play, that is part of his game.
And Gafford with the block. Count it. Holmes has got six. If they play this right, they can go two for one.
Yeah, they really have to work the clock right now.
And here's Wright from the arc. Knocks down the long J. And the Wizards lead by one.
This is what it's been since halftime. Remarkable results from downtown.
Yeah, pretty infectious right here, guys. In good spirits and percentages from downtown on the rise in the second half.
Stolen by Herter. Pass to Fox. The layup off target. We're at the end of the third quarter, and we've still got a close one. It's the Wizards leading by a point. We've reached the fourth quarter in what has been a very competitive game. Should be an exciting finish. To the paint. Back to Monk. It's Bazemore on the wing. Uses the glass to finish the layup. Bazemore's got his first points of the game.
Bazemore looking pretty comfortable on the inside there, weaving around for that two.
Morris, right side. From deep, Barton. Kept alive. The Kings leading. And Monte Morris is going to pick up the foul. That's his first foul of the game.
First personal foul. First team foul.
Picked by Holmes. Monk with it. Porzingis picks him up defensively. And the basket by Monk.
Can't ask for a better look with the game in the balance.
Beal outside. Puts it up. No good. And the Kings going the other way now. Oh, Beal picks his pocket.
Genesi Mensu. First personal foul. First team foul.
We played just over a minute here in the fourth. From the wing. And stolen by Herter.
And it's pretty simple. I mean, once you leave your feet, you leave yourself with very few options.
Pass to Beal. And Holmes pulls it down. Outside Herter. Here's Bazemore. The three. Doesn't go for him. Here's Morris. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line. Well, Brent, this Kings franchise looking to turn things around. It's been years since they've contended.
Yeah, B.A., you don't ever really want to get specific with win totals on a year, but how nice would it be for the Kings to hit that 40-win mark and really get themselves into the postseason? Just hoping this recent coaching change will give them that boost to finally have some postseason basketball in Sacramento.
Sabonis misses from close range.
Defense is tough as it comes right there. He's a hard man to deny when he gets the ball to the rim.
Beal's shot is off.
He's not sure if he ran out of energy at halftime or what, but so far just not himself in the second half.
And the foul called on Kristaps Porzingis. That's his third foul so far. Fourth quarter play. We're about 2.5 minutes through it now. Cox, that's good.
De'Aaron Fox.
Fox has got 24.
Tough matchup here, and Fox has it going right now. The lefty getting some room and making it happen.
Now a timeout called by Washington. All right, let's check in with Allie LaForce.
I was able to listen in on what Wes Unseld Jr. had to say to his team. He asked his players to really push the tempo. He wants to see quicker transition into the open court so they have a chance to score before the defense can set up, trying to use their speed to full advantage, guys.
As always, Allie, we thank you.
And the anticipation from Barton there off the charts. That's a great feed.
Sabonis, left side. Out to the wing. Here's Murray. Oh, it's blocked by Porzingis.
And Porzingis showing some of those signs from early on in his career. He was a great shot blocker.
And it's Kuzma finishing it off.
And Kuz on the cruise with that bucket.
Got a piece of it. Pass to Sabonis. Now here's Fox. Well, if you're just tuning in, welcome. We played about 3.5 minutes into the fourth quarter here. Sabonis can't hit.
I know he's on a cold streak, but he can't let that get in his head.
Especially if you're a player that doesn't get a lot of shot attempts. But otherwise, the mindset is, I just got to get the next one to go. And you don't want to put that much pressure on yourself.
And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up. And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The scoring breakdown for the Wizards.
Their offensive game plan has been simple. Look to shoot it often from outside the arc. And the results have been outstanding.
Now a timeout by Sacramento.
Here they come, DC Bentley.
Second free throw is good.
He was able to tie it up. He has to be disappointed that he could not give his team the lead.
Now a timeout called by Washington. Washington with it. Here's Beal. For three. Knocks down the triple. Beal's got 11 points here in the second half.
Man, I'll tell you what, the pressure is cranked up. Who better to call
than this guy.
Out to the right wing. Fox, right side. Back to Murray. Out to Fox. Shot clock at five. Lays it up and banks it in. Fox has got 26.
De'Aaron Fox stepping up big time.
And here's Beal. Pass to Kuzma. Puts up a three. Called in by the Kings.
Well, even though he misses that one, the defense has got to talk about that. That's a bad miscue. And you can't give up looks like that all game long.
Neither team able to build the lead and sustain it.
After six lead changes, it feels like it could come down to one big play.
They kick it out to Porzingis. Pass to Wright.
First person of that. Third team. Same substitution. DeMontis Sabonis.
Here's Wright. Beal outside. Four on the clock.
Holmes sees that shot coming and says, goodbye.
Here's Fox. Counted!
Wow. That takes steady nerves right there.
Not backing down from this moment here. When the game is close, he kicks it up a notch.
Beal from outside. Barnes with the rebound.
I think if I was coaching these guys right now, especially him, I'd tell him, you take one more three-point shot, we're going to have some conversations here side by side.
Timeout called. The Kings. They're on top by three. We've got 22 seconds left to the fourth. Boy, this offense has been dynamic and diversified.
Just everyone sharing the ball and sharing the load makes you difficult to defend.
Good on the first. And that gives him a four-point cushion.
Now, part of being a point guard like Fox is you handle the ball a lot and you get a lot of opportunities late in the game. So clutch free throws are something you have to be ready for.
Pass to Kuzma. Beal from outside. That doesn't go either for Beal. And now they foul and stop the clock.
And a smart choice right there. I mean, you can't allow them to just drain the clock.
Ooh, he doesn't hit the first. That was the one they really wanted. He's got one more, though.
Well, the big man has a good touch. We'll see if Rashawn Holmes can touch these two up.
And the Wizards call time here. They're losing by five. Just 4 seconds left in the fourth quarter. All right, guys, what's your take?
Too little, too late. Making a change won't save them now.
Well, I'm going to use the cliche here. You can't take your timeouts with you, so they're going to use it.
So the Kings win it, and they barely squeezed out the win here on the road.
NBA, the visiting team is always under some added pressure, but they made it work and got the win, whatever the margin may have been.
And that's...